Hi, Peter here from U-Render. In this video, I will give you an overview of our new Sheen material effect. Sheen can be used to simulate the effect of fine microstructures, like fine filaments or hairs. So it is helpful for materials like cloth, velvet, microfibers, but also to get a better result for materials like skin and fruits. Here I have the field force scene you also can find in the asset browser. It's a very good cloth testing scene that was created with the field force object and spherical fields. It shows that you can do nice cloth simulations without using soft bodies. The first thing you need is at least one direct light source like Omni, Spot or Aerial Light to see the sheen effect. Then activate the sheen channel. It is energy conserving and layered onto the diffuse channel. This means that the diffuse color gets a bit darker, so keep that in mind. First, we have the falloff type that is sinus by default. You can switch to Gaussian, that gives a different distribution of the sheen gradient. Next, you can set the sheen color. Depending on the use case, it can be a good idea to match the sheen color with the diffuse color instead of using default white. Also, the color of the light source influences the sheen color. So keep it in mind when tweaking your material. The weight slider adjusts how strong the sheen effect appears on your object. The weight texture does not influence the sheen color. It defines where the sheen effect appears stronger or weaker. So I recommend using grayscale textures. Of course, you can use color textures, but the color information will be ignored. The glossiness slider lets you define how soft the sheen gradient looks like. With these few settings, you can make nice effects and increase the appearance of cloth materials. But sheen is also very useful for other materials, so you can make a peach out of a nectarine or also use it in a more abstract way. I hope you have fun with sheen and that it will help you create even more stunning materials for your scenes. Thanks for watching.